हेलो। ओके, वेलकम ऑन अ ब्राइट संडे मॉर्निंग। आई नो इट्स ऑलवेज अ डे ऑफ रेस्ट फॉर पीपल हु आर वर्किंग सो हार्ड फॉर आवर सेल्व्स एज आर आवर फैमिलीज। I'd like to first and foremost thank you for your time. I'm sure we've come here because we've got a high level of interest in the future of our children. My name is Bipin Wadhwa, and I am a parent of a 19-year-old child. I've got nephews and nieces who are of the age between 2013 and 26, and all of my friends and nephews, they all are looking at one simple question. In today's market, what is it that will happen to us in terms of our careers in our future? This is a burning question which most of us keep facing, and this is the reason why we thought we would like to have this webinar set up primarily so that we can look at what is it that we as parents could do. Could I request you to share with you your expectations from what we would like to discuss in this webinar, as you can put your points around in the Q&A panel. Anybody? Okay, so what I will do is to lay out what I thought would be the best beliefs that we would like to focus on. The entire focus has been on our past, which is around our career goals, what we would like to see and adjust to in focusing on what is it that we would like to consider in our. Good morning, Arupa. Are would bringing in our own experiences and setting up what is it that we would like to see for our children. Now, the entire market has been changing, and it's been changing very drastically. But do our children deserve a happy, fulfilling career? Obviously, yes. What we would like to see is how we would like to create an opportunity for them in setting up a good life for them. And for that, we would like to first and foremost see what is it that we have. What we have created for ourselves. For me, the most important question that I would have to answer for myself is, can I have a career for my child who can focus on his or her strengths? Can I have a career goal that I need to set up? Can I create something that I may be able to tell my child that, look, this is your career, you create an option, and you create the future for yourself. Imagine that 40 years, at the age of 40, the children that you and I have, how would they be living their careers? Would they be living in a job or work? Employed in an area that they are happy and fulfilled? Can I say, truly say that they are financially independent? Can I say that they have respect? Can I say that they are doing what they love to do? What is it that will give them that satisfaction? To answer that question, I first started looking at my own career journal. I started at the age of 14 to ask this question for myself. This was in 1983, when I started looking at what is it that I could do. And my mother would tell me options as to what I could do in terms of, can I take science or can I take commerce? In 1984, when I completed my 10th, when I was given a test and I was told, look, you're good at numbers, you're good at logic, why don't you take engineering? And I came from a family of businessmen, so I said, okay, no, my focus should be around commerce. So I decided to take commerce. I then looked at what could happen in business, and somehow I was not feeling up to it. And I met an uncle who was into chartered accountant. He was fairly successful, money, and that attracted me, money and somebody who was qualified. So I decided to take chartered accountancy. At that point of time, I loved performing arts. I was into dramatics. But I decided that it is not important for me to do dramatics because I don't know what I could do. I don't know the market. What I know is that there is an uncle who has been fairly successful. So let me take that on. I did my chartered accountancy. I was good with numbers. And I got my first break in a company called Pricewaterhouse. And I spent 7 years there. But within that 7 years, I took the jobs that came my way. And my next opportunity always depended upon the jobs that I had done in the past. Based on the work that I kept doing and improving and evolving, I got my next opportunity. That's how I got into IT and ITES industry. At the age of 28, I got married, settled down, came to Bangalore. I by then had worked for two companies, ICICI OneSource and Pricewaterhouse. Because I had worked in Pricewaterhouse, I had taken up risk management, assurance. I got an NX break in Infosys for risk management. And then I moved on to doing consulting just because in one case, because I had worked in Pricewaterhouse, I could be a good consultant. And therefore, I got my next break as a consultant advisor and a solution architect. Suddenly, at the age of 45, I started asking myself, what is it that I have been doing? Why I do feel that there is a crisis? Why is it that the market is, I have been running to stay where I am? And that's when I realized that the market has completely changed. It is completely changing. And that evolution has already so much started that the market that we saw in the past is not the market that we will be seeing now and not the market that we will be perhaps seeing in the future. In this context, what was happening was that my entire focus was to run to stay where I am. If I look back, my focus was what is the right education that I should take? My focus was focusing on what is it that could succeed, and I was looking at the outside market. I was focusing on the job that I could get a break, and I was focusing on what I could do next based on what I had done earlier. When I started asking myself, is this the right thing that one should look at in our careers? And is that the right thing that is the best way to look at it? I started asking this question of people who were into career management. And then I came across one key fact. Did we look at our own strengths to be able to decide what should be our career goal and work towards it? Or did we just go ahead and let the events take place one after the other? That to me created a burning question. What is it that we are doing for our children, and what am I doing for my children? Can I truly say that I am in a position that I can perhaps be able to be a good guide to my child? Does this resonate with you? Can I honestly ask myself, do I know enough of the market? Can I tell my child, look, you can look at your education, but what is it that you could be tomorrow? That's when I came across a study by Dhaya Mentors, and they held a study which said that just about 78% of the children do not know what they'd like to do, what they'd like to be. And those who knew were largely focusing on what they could be as an engineer, IPS officer, police, basically generic words that we listen to from their peers, from our parents, from the educational institutions. There are about a set of 100 odd words, if you really look at it, that you and I could as such get to know, which could be termed as careers. Is that enough for us to really create a goal for our children, and they could look at a goal for themselves? What's the purpose of life for them in terms of their career? Are they aware enough about themselves and their market, the market that they are getting into? And for us as parents to see what is it that we would like to actually be able to share in terms of our knowledge and expectations. What I'm going to talk about now is around the studies that I have come across based on their work and field of work. There is a community of about 100 odd work researchers and master mentors, along with a community of about 1,000 CDFs, which is career development facilitators, whose experience I'm going to talk about in terms of what we could look at and do in terms of providing a path for our children to be able to focus on what is it that their goals could be. Look, we've actually looked at a completely set of beliefs that the market drives careers for us. We've put in our belief that education is the only way to create careers, or if we have existing business, then get in the business at the right time. The business will take care of for the children. But look at it this way. The market is ever changing and evolving. Can those paradigms or beliefs help us and our children? To me, it's a very different paradigm. The paradigm is, is it about our children, or is it about just what they could do in the market? I think first and foremost, our paradigms is that the career of my child is unique. My child's career goals have to be driven by the personality and the strengths that is discovered from the child within. And it has to be rewarding enough for the child to be able to follow their dreams. This to me means that there are four things that I would need to look at. First, my own parenting style. I have an expectation. I have had an experience. My own style would be about nurturing. And how many of us are looking at nurturing our child to get not only in life, but also in the careers? The path to the entire career goals has to not just be looked at from the education, but monetary gain, but from a fulfilling occupation and financial independence. What it means that at any given point of time, the child is able to follow their dreams, create financial independence, so that by a certain age of target, they will be able to do what they love to do. But why not now? Why can the career goal not be driven by the entire strengths and capabilities and interests that my child has? Can I not plan for the child's future? I could look at it as I do not wish to plan enough because I don't know what future may hold for me, for the child. But don't I plan when I'm into work, business, employment? They do. Not targets, plan, mission, purpose. So you see, if I am able to plan, what is it then what is it that I could do in terms of my planning? I need to be aware of the fact that when I create a plan, I need to be aware of my child's strengths. So I need to be able to discover strengths, not only what the child has that I know, but the child may have inherently, which I would also like to know, as much as to make the child aware of their strengths. To be able to then identify where are the strengths going to be able to put to use and how they will be able to modulate, or what would be then the means for gainful employment. Gone are the days when we would always say, think that A, business, B, only jobs are the best ways to gain employment. The fact is that there are now four ways or means that the child needs to understand and equipped enough to be able to work out how they could get employed. But before that, it's equally important to understand that for the child to understand not only their strengths, but also the areas that they could have interests in, as well as their capabilities. That increases the success, not only the successful rate, but if I'll start doing what my strengths are, as compared to what are the areas that I need to constantly keep improving in terms of weaknesses or performance improvement plan, the chances of satisfaction is drastically increased. So I need to work with my strengths. And if I'm working on my strengths, where are the opportunities lying? Well, in terms of our market, there is enough and more that is coming. Is just that we need to be able to match the strengths to the market realities. The reality today is that employability is key. Yep. What's happened is technology has got converged into business models, and it has also impacted. There's another change that is happening. There's a cultural change that is coming. We keep focusing on technology, but what we can see is that there is a view around the impact of culture. Whether I call it global culture, whether I call it market is getting closer, new ways and means of reduced effort in just about any field, whether I know about the operations or telecom or maybe even agriculture, connectedness reduced effort, more information is becoming a huge reality today, and that increasingly is actually what is increasingly what is happening is that the manual efforts and the rule-based work has started reducing. We understand that. Insights is the power. We understand that. But other thing that is happening is that there has been a significant increase, at least in India, in terms of the educated population. So competition is also increasing. But having said that, the competition is increasing, and there is more people that are available, because the business models are increasing, the realities of the work, nature of work that is in, now coming into fore and emerging, as well as the what is going to emerge, those are also changing. And in fact, there are more opportunities that are also coming by. It's just about that we need to be ready for it. And for that, we cannot get restricted to those 100 generic careers that we can focus on. My career goal for my child, the child has to be able to look at many more options that you could have both today and in the future. For example, today, there are about 22,000 occupations that are that you could consider for the child. And the child needs to can look at what is it, in what area of occupation he could be in based on his abilities to focus on what is it that he would like to be in terms of the his goal of the you know, the whether he would like to be a researcher, or whether he would like to be a analyst, or whether he would like to be into networking or sales. They are all categories of careers that the child can now pick on. And the combination of where it can be applied can then be linked to the various occupations. That can help us to address the ability to for the child to be employable. How do I do this? In terms of our four-step way in which I could look at, first and foremost, I need to understand that my child is unique. So we get down to understanding a complete set of strengths that a child has. And those strengths are around the personality strengths, the interests, the aptitude and the attitude, and the complete view of what the kind of profile the child would could have. That then can be looked at to match the occupations that are there, which are possible. To create the career direction. I'll give you an example. I have a close friend whose nephew came to me. He came to me last week, and he spent time with me on what is it that he could do or in terms of his careers. Now, he comes from a business family, and he's looking at an option where he wanted to know what he could do rather than just getting running into his business. Because in his business, he wanted to do something different. And he had spent a year in running his father's hotel. This is in Mangalore. However, the need to do something more, something different, kept on coming up to him because he had done his engineering. And where does he use his engineering knowledge? When we made his assessment, what came out for him is, A, we discovered, he discovered or rediscovered that He is a person who is brilliant in networks. He's a relationship builder. He loves talking. He's a gregarious person. He is a person who will be able to talk through anything that you give him, as well as that he's creative. He has the ability to analyze. What is his capability? Analysis. He's got logic. He has the ability to be very, very creative. What is his personality? His personality is that of a people's person. He's a relationship builder. So what are the areas that interested him? Interestingly, agriculture, politics, service, creation of any new idea were things that were enthusiastic for him. So if you were to look at this profile of his, where could he actually use it? We were able to identify that based on his areas of interest, he could look at where he could apply in terms of A, use his logic and his people ability to the traditional areas that exist in market today of solution architect and solution development that are prevalent in most of the product development and or service industry, especially the ITES industry. Because it involves sales. At the same time, it involves sales convincing. And it requires something creative. And there's an element of visualization, logical visualization that he has is involved. At the same time, what we could see is that his relationship building can help him come up with options where he could actually create market network, perhaps in terms of an agency or in terms of his ability to conduct sales, especially in fields where he's able to create this huge market networking, and he'll be able to get any product and then he can network that through. Can he do that? Market reality says you can, because that's where this market is building. It's all about persuasion and perception management, isn't it? And we said that yes, we both decided that yes, that's an option he could take. The third area that he could look at was that he loves politics. He's interested in servicing the country. At the same time, he knows that he can talk through a lot of groups. He can organize groups. Isn't that something that the new world, new politics is looking at? So then we created career options for him in terms of choosing occupations, where we could look at architect, we could look at relationship building for in terms of networking in agency, or he could look at politics. And we added his key interest in agriculture. So he could actually work in the agricultural field using his creativity and create network with farmers, which is a big need today. Because ruralization, smart villages also means that bringing together farmers, creating new ideas for them, marketing it across for them, and creating not just awareness, but ability to implement new ways of working for them is something that is a need. There is a trend, there is a future in it. It's an option because today their own market requires it, and he has that ability. Now, how do we does that? There has to be a plan for it. He's got a network. How does he reach out to some other people to be able to do that, to achieve his dream? And what is the education that he requires for that? He's picked up engineering, and next he will pick up geographical information systems, data analysis, because analysis is one of his strengths, but he's going to get linked to his relationship building. So the choice he made was that I want to be somebody worthy who can create relationships. So I am a relationship builder in the field of agriculture, networking people, and getting first an employment and then setting up my own entrepreneurship to be able to achieve my dream. It's about connecting his strengths to the various occupations a person has. Does that resonate with us? Is it applicable to everybody? Not necessarily. His own brother is unique. His own strengths, he's a very reserved person as compared to his brother. His brother is not gregarious. He's very introvert. How do I know that he's an introvert? Not just because he keeps quiet, but when you do his assessment, you're able to see that he's a person who is a thinker. He wants to, he is very diligent. He wants to understand before he acts. That creates him to become a sort of an introvert who has this brilliant ability to be dexterous, learn very, very fast. And his interest is adventure and sports. It is his personality with his capability of being able to pick up something very quickly, his ability to create possibilities around what is it that he could do in terms of using his strengths of his logical visualizations and dexterity, that we could see why he was also good in sports. He is a badminton player. He's into playing nationals. And for him, a clear course for him is that he could be in the fields of sports as a person who is able to be deep into a physical activity and mechanical person. Mechanical, not in terms of machine, mechanical as in using hands, feet, legs, eyes, using his personality for doing audits and being very, very thorough. So whichever field he chooses, as long as he's able to focus on these strengths, he will be able to do well. And that was then proven when he was 3 weeks back called in for the national championships because he was able to use his strengths well. His occupation, because he would like to be in this, and because it's also important for him that he should also be able to sustain his interest. What were the options that we could look at for him? He could go on and get into the field of sports and manage sports in terms of coach. But at the same time, we could also see that the other area that he could look at is the armed forces, because it just maps up to his continuing in his sports. At the same time, he will also be able to serve the nation. And his physical dexterity clearly shows that that's something that the armed forces could use. Remember, because he's a person who thinks well, strategy is one area that the armed forces could use him for, because a lot of it is quick strategy and quick thinking, and that's what his strengths are. So that are the example, two distinct examples I could give you. My own son will have his own uniqueness. Your children will have their own uniqueness. But what is the path to come up with their goal? The goal could be based on A, knowing their strengths, assessing it. And there are the assessment can be done across about 20 strengths, personalities, 13 personalities, number of capabilities, around 18 capabilities, 20 more interests, or whatever the person's interests would be, and combining that with what the possibilities of the future. That's the career options one could look at. But what does it involve? It does involve a rigor. I personally have used this 7D model, which has been proven successful for career development. It discovers the child, gives a direction to the child, helps us to design the career goals. Because it is a choice that the child is making, the desire to be able to achieve that increases in the child, because it's a dream that the child is coming up with. And together, how we can help develop the dreams and goals into reality. So that, unlike many careers where events determine where we are, the control the areas that you could work, the assessments that have to be done to understand not only what we know about a child, but also what we don't know about the child. And I think it's also important that the baton passes on to the child, because finally it's the child's future. So how do we help the child discover the child's strengths in terms of its capabilities, in terms of its interests, in terms of the personality and the behaviors, and where it can be best put to use, can then in the emerging markets, can then be put to use well by the child, and we can thus guide them.